गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 and 6 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 8.3। क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 सेज आई बाय अ टीवी फॉर रुपीज 10,000 एंड सेल इट एट अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ 20%। हाउ मच मनी डू आई गेट फॉर इट? आई हैव बॉट वन टीवी हुज कॉस्ट प्राइस इज 10,000, right? And I sell it on 20% profit. That means this is given is profit percentage. Now what they want us from? What they want us to do? That is how much money do I get for it? That is the selling price. Selling price, at what selling price I have sold the TV. And you know from the introductory lecture, if I show you, profit is equal to selling price minus CP. If I want to carry out selling price, what I will do? I will take this minus CP to this side. So my SP will be cost price plus profit amount. So if I want to find SP, what I should do? I must knowing cost price and the profit. Here it is given profit percent, but I want profit amount, which I don't have. So what I will do? My target is to find profit amount. And for that purpose, I will write whatever they have given. I will write cost price of TV is equal to rupees 10,000. Profit percent is equal to 20%. So therefore, from profit percent I can find profit amount. Therefore profit amount is equal to whatever the profit percent, 20% of what? Of CP. So 20% will be written as 20 divided by 100 multiply by 10,000. Two zeros from here will cut out. 100 into 2, 200 plus 1 zero of 20. So my profit will be 2,000 rupees. Now since I have got profit amount, I will put it here and I will get my selling price. Therefore, SP is equal to cost price plus profit amount, which is equal to cost price is 10,000 plus profit amount is 2,000, which will be rupees 12,000. So at the end, what I will write? I will get rupees 12,000. Got? So you will write like this. I got rupees 12,000 on selling the TV. Now moving to question number 6, let me first write it down. So the question says like this: Juhi sells a washing machine for rupees 13,500. Juhi, one girl, sold her washing machine, which she was selling. She sold it for rupees 13,500. She losses 20% in the bargain. And now when she was selling and while doing bargaining, she lost 20%. That means she sold it on loss. What was the price at which she bought? And we are supposed to find the cost price at what she bought. So since we are supposed to find the cost price and we don't know, I will write, let the cost price CP of washing machine? B, rupees X. Now, students, I want to find the cost price, but if you see logically, let me explain you in the rough portion here. The selling price, this is the selling price, and this selling price, if I am having a loss, how is the calculation made? Calculation is made like this: whatever the cost price and you are selling it in loss, so I will be subtracting the loss amount from here, then only I will get the selling price. Already we are having the selling price, that is 13,500. What we are not having is cost price, that we have taken as X, and loss amount we will be carrying out from the 20% loss that we are having. So let us focus over here, and then we will solve continuously in the rough portion also. So I will write like this, whatever they have given us, I will write selling price of machine, that is washing machine, is equal to rupees 13,500. Loss percent is equal to 20%. Now, since I have to find loss amount, I will write loss amount is equal to 20%. 20% on what? Definitely on the cost price, which we don't know, but we have assumed it as X. So I will write 20%, I will write divide by 100 into cost price is X. So my loss amount will be 00 will be cancelled out, 2 1s are and 2 5s are. So X 1s are X divide by 5 will be my loss amount. So I have got loss amount. I have supposed cost price. So I will put it in this equation and I will get the answer. Therefore, selling price is equal to cost price minus loss amount. What was the cost price? X. What was the selling price? 13,500. And what is the loss amount? X divided by 5. We will take LCM of this side, and this side we will keep as it is. 13,500 is equal to 5 1s are 5, that is 5x minus X divided by 5. This calculation will give me this 5. If I multiply over here, it will be 13,500 multiplied by 5 is equal to 5x minus X will be 4x. So 4x is equal to 135 into 5. Let me calculate over here. 135 into 5. 5 5s are 25. 2 carry. 5 3s are 15. 17. 1 carry. 5 1s are 5. And 1 6 and 2 zeros. So I will get 67,500. That implies I want the value of X. So I will keep X as it is and divide the 4. On dividing the 4, what I will get? Four ones are 4. 4 6 are 24. 4 8s are 32. 4 7s are 24. 4 7s are 28, sorry. And 4 5s are 20. Let me calculate. Okay, 4 5 is 20. So my cost price was 16,875. Therefore, X is equal to 16,875 rupees. So I will write, therefore, Juhi bought the machine, that is washing machine, at 16,875. So this was all for today's lecture, but some of the students have requested me that sir, please, if you can solve the question number 2, part number C and D. So let me solve for them. Question number 2 in that part C is having 1:4. So what we are used to solve? We are given the ratio is equal to 1:4, and sum of the ratio is 1+4, that is 5. Now percentage of first part is equal to 1 out of how many part? 5 part multiplied by 100. 5 20 is equal to 21 is 20%. Similarly, percentage of second part is equal to, what is the second part? 4 out of how many? 5 into 100. Percentage 5 1s, 5 20s, and 24s is 80%. So this was the part C. Now let me solve part D. Part D says 1:2:5. The ratio they have given us is 1:2:5. So I will write ratio is equal to 1:2:5. That means sum of the ratio is equal to 1+2+5, and that will be 8 parts. Now percentage of first part is 1 out of how many part? 8 parts into 100. Now percentage, so 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, and 4 25s are 100. So I will get 25/2 percentage, which I can write 12.5% divided by 2. Similarly, percentage of second part is equal to, second part is 2, out of total part is 8 into 100. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 25s are 100. 2 will cancel out, so I will be remaining with 25%. Percentage of third part is equal to, third part is 5, 5 divided by total part is 8 into 100. 4 2s are 8, 4 25s are 100. 25 5s are 125 divided by 2. Yes, 25 5s are 125 divided by 2, that will give me 62.5%. So this was all for today's lecture. Hope you have got the remaining part also solved, but try it yourself, as it was very easy. I have given you in the homework. So please, next time try to solve on your own. We will be meeting with new videos in new lecture. Till then, take care of yourself. Stay home, stay safe. Bye bye.